In the case we have multivariate data, we are dealing with a data set X, just like before, consisting of data points XT with T from 1 to N, except that this time these data points XT are d-dimensional, so they are in R to power D. And the multivariate kernel density estimator is in this case p hat of x is similar as before. It's 1 over n times, it's not just h, but it's h to power d, because we have a box with h on all d dimensions. And then it's a sum from for all the data points of this kernel function applied to x minus x to power t over h. And obviously the argument to this kernel function is now a d-dimensional vector. And you have to choose the kernel function carefully, and in particular it should be in such a way that it integrates to 1. So the integral over r to power d of kx should be equal to 1. And there are several different options how to go about this. One option is similar to the one we had on the one-dimensional case, the multivariate Gaussian kernel. And in this case, its form is k of u is 1 over square root of 2 pi 2 power d exponent of minus the norm of u squared over 2. And one thing that you should really be very careful about when you deal with multivariate data is this so-called curse of dimensionality. And what this means is that you have to be careful how do you choose you know, the beans. Just to give you an example, if you have x to be 8-dimensional and you would like to use a histogram with 10 beans per dimension, then right away altogether you have 10 to power 8 8-dimensional beans. And unless you have a lot of data, in practice it's going to turn out that most of these, or the vast majority of these beans, are going to be empty, and the estimates in them is going to be zero. And so this has to be carefully considered, how to choose the beans, where to place them, and how many to choose, so that you have a reasonable number of them with a non-empty distribution. One other comment I want to make is that the use of the Euclidean norm in this multivariate Gaussian kernel implies that the kernel is scaled equally on all d dimensions. And if that's not the case, then the first thing you should do before you are applying the Gaussian kernel is to normalize them so that they have the same variance. And that's going to help somewhat. It still has the disadvantage that it doesn't take the correlations into account. And if you are in such a case where the correlations are indeed important, then and non-zero, then it may be that you could use a different form of the Gaussian kernel, where instead of the Euclidean distance, you are using something else. And in this case, in fact, you should take the covariance matrix into account, and you would have in this case 1 over 2 pi 2 power d over 2 times the determinant of s 2 power 1 over 2 times exponent of minus 1 over 2 u transposed s to power minus 1 u, where obviously S is the sample covariance matrix. And this corresponds to using the Mahalanobis distance instead of the Euclidean distance, and it integrates into the kernel function the various correlations between the dimensions of your data.